નમસ્કાર, હું આદર્શ છું. વેલકમ ટુ આદર્શ એજ્યુકેશન સોસાયટી. ટુડે ઇન સ્ટાન્ડર્ડ 9th સબ્જેક્ટ મેથેમેટિક્સ વી આર ગોઈંગ ટુ લર્ન ચેપ્ટર 12 હેરોન્સ ફોર્મ્યુલા.
ટુડે ઇન એક્સરસાઇઝ 12.2 ક્વેશ્ચન નંબર 5. ધેર ઇઝ અ રમ્બસ શેપ્ડ ફિલ્ડ ધેટ હેઝ ગ્રીન ગ્રાસ For 18 cows, it has green grass for 18 cows. Number of cows for which the green grass is there, that is 18. Here there are 18 cows, and each side of the rhombus, which is filled with green grass, has 30 centimeter, and one of its diagonal is 48 meter. Here 30 meter and 48 meter. 30 meter is the length of each side, and diagonal, one of the diagonal is 48 meter. Then how much area of the grass field, this is a grass field, then how much area of the grass field will each cow be getting? So here number of cows are 18, so if we find the area of this rhombus, then we'll get the area of grass for 18 cows will get, and then we have to find the area of cows for area for one cow, area of grass for one cow. So now to find the area of this rhombus, diagonal is given. As we know, as diagonal divides rhombus into two congruent triangles. Two congruent triangles. And so, if we find the area of one triangle, then the other triangle also has the same area. So, let us find out the area of one triangle. So, to find the area of one triangle, the sides of triangle are, the sides of triangle are, here suppose we say A is equal to 30 meter, B is equal to 30 meter, and C is equal to 48 meter. So we can find the area of this triangle. Same way, area of another triangle is same because the two triangles are congruent. So therefore, to find this, we have to first of all find semi-perimeter to find the area of this triangle using Heron's formula. So A plus B plus C, sum of three sides divided by 2. And that is 30 plus 30, 60 plus 48, 108 divided by 2. 108 divided by 2, and that is 54 meter. So 54 meter is the semi-perimeter of the triangle. Therefore, area of triangle is equal to, here formula, semi-perimeter into semi-perimeter minus one side, semi-perimeter minus another side, semi-perimeter minus third side. And so substituting the value here, 54 in bracket, 54 minus 30, 54 minus 30, 54 minus 48. So here we'll get square root of 54 multiplied by 54 minus 30, that is 24, 54 minus 30, 24, and 54 minus 48 is 6. So we will get here square root of here 9, 6 cha 54, 24 into 24 into 6, and thus we will get the area here is equal to square root of here 9 multiplied by 6 2 times and 24 2 times, and that is equal to 3, square root of 9, square root of this 6 square, and square root of 24 square, and 24 into, so 3 6 cha 18 24 cha, so that is 432 meter square. This is the area of one triangle, area of one triangle. So what about the area of another triangle? Area of another triangle is also same. So therefore, area of another triangle is also 432 meter square. Thus, the total area of the rhombus containing grass for 18 cows is equal to 432 plus 432, that is 864 meter square. This is the area of grass in the field in the shape of rhombus for 18 cows. So therefore our question is to find how much area of grass is there for each cow. So here area of grass for 18 cows is equal to area of grass for 18 cows is equal to 864 meter square, and therefore area of grass for each cow or one cow is equal to 864 meter square divided by 18. So when we cut 864 is actually 432 twos are, and 432 means here we have already done calculation, that is 2 times 432, that is 432 factors are 3 into 6 into 24 multiplied by 2 divided by 18. So 6 threes are 18. So here we will get 2 into 24, that is 48 meter square is the area of grass in this rhombus field in the shape of rhombus for each cow. In question 6, an umbrella is there. Here the umbrella is made up of made by stitching 10 triangular pieces. Here out of that 5 triangular pieces you can see, so total 10 triangular pieces are there to make the umbrella, and that is made up of two different colors, 5 pieces of one color and another 5 pieces of another color alternate. Here you can see we can say here one color here, another color here, and another color here. So 5 pieces of each color, and each triangular here, each side or each piece has the measures 20 centimeter, 50 centimeter and 50 centimeter. How much cloth of each color is required for umbrella? There are total 2 colors for 10 triangles. So what is the area of each color which has 5 triangles? So first of all we will find the area of each triangular piece, and for that the sides are given 20 centimeter, 50 centimeter and 50 centimeter, and therefore semi perimeter to find the area of each triangular piece is equal to A plus B plus C divided by 2, and that is 20 plus 50 plus 50, that is 120 divided by 2. And that is equal to here 60 centimeter. So 60 centimeter is the semi perimeter. Therefore, area of each triangular piece is equal to, using Heron's formula, we can find area of each piece. Triangular piece of this umbrella. So here semi perimeter is 60 minus 20, 60 minus 50, 60 minus 50, and thus we get here square root of 60 multiplied by here 60 minus 20, that is 40, multiplied by here 10 multiplied by 10. And thus we get square root of here 6 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 10 square multiplied by 10 square. And that is, we say here 2 multiplied by 10 multiplied by 10 multiplied by root 6. And that is, we get 200 root 6 centimeter square is the area of each triangular piece of this umbrella. Now therefore, our question is to find area of 5 triangular pieces or area of each color. So here now, to find the area of 5 triangular pieces of one color, therefore area of 5 triangular pieces of one color is equal to 5 multiplied by area of each piece. Here 5 multiplied by area of each piece, we have calculated 200 root 6, and that is 1000 root 6 centimeter square is the area of 5 triangular pieces of one color. And here all the pieces, triangular pieces, are equivalent or congruent, have the equal area, and therefore area of another 5 triangular pieces, 5 triangular pieces of other color is equal to same area, 5 into this, that is 1000 root 6 centimeter square. So each color has the area, each color of triangular pieces has the area 1000 root 6 centimeter square. In question 7, a kite is in the shape of square. A kite is in the shape of square with diagonal 32 centimeter. And here in square kite, the diagonals are equal. So each 32 centimeter, and also diagonals are perpendicular bisectors. Therefore, these both the diagonals are perpendicular, forms right angle, and also each bisect, here diagonals bisect each other. And it has isosceles triangle base with 8 centimeter side, 6 centimeter and 6 centimeter. Isosceles triangle here for kite. Now how much paper? Here the one paper for this, one paper for this region, one paper for this region. So here 3 colored papers are used. So how much paper of each shade 1, 2 and 3 has been used to make this kite? Here each diagonal of square kite 32 centimeter, so height of each diagonal, height of each triangle, this height is 16, that is half of 32, because diagonals bisect each other. So this is also 32, this is also 32, so this height is half of 32, that is 16 centimeter, that is 16 centimeter. Then dimensions of the isosceles triangle here are 8 centimeter, 6 and 6 centimeter for third region, and this is perpendicular, as diagonals are perpendicular bisector, it forms right angle. Therefore, this is called altitude and this is called base for this triangle. So, for this triangle, as it is a diagonal, it divided into two congruent triangles. So, area of the second region is same as the area of the first region, and then area of third region. So, we have to find the area of each piece of paper. So, let us find out, first of all, therefore, for area of shade 1 and 2, semi perimeter, for this area of shade 1 and 2, area of paper of shade 1 is equal to area of paper of shade 2. Both the shade have the same color paper. Here area of color paper of each shade 1 and 2, they are equal. And as it is perpendicular bisector, here we can use the formula half of base into altitude. Half of base into altitude. So that is half of base is here 32 centimeter and altitude is 16. So 216 ja. So 16 ja 256 centimeter square. This is the area of paper of said region 1, that is said 1, and another paper of another color of said 2, that is region 2. Now for area of paper of said or the region 3, as it is isosceles triangle, we have to find semi perimeter A plus B plus C divided by 2. A, that is here 8 centimeter plus 6 centimeter plus 6 centimeter divided by 2, and that is 20 by 2, and that is 10 centimeter. So 10 centimeter is a semi perimeter, and therefore area of paper of said 3, that is third region, is equal to square root of semi perimeter into semi perimeter minus one side, semi perimeter minus another side, and semi perimeter minus third side. So here square root of here semi perimeter 10 multiplied by 10 minus 8 multiplied by 10 minus 6 multiplied by 10 minus 6, and thus we get here square root of 10 into 2 into 4 into 4. Here it is 5 multiplied by 2 into 2 into 4 into 4, as 5 to the 10. Okay, so now here we will get square root of 5 into 2 square into 4 square, and that is 2 into 4 multiplied by root 5, and that is equal to 8 root 5 centimeter square. Now we can convert root 5 into decimal, and so up to 2 decimal places root 5 is equal to 2.24 approximately, and that is equal to 8 multiplied by 2.24, and that is 17.92 centimeter square. This is the approximate value up to 2 decimal places. So this is approximately the area of the paper of the said or the said third, that is here the region or the said third said, area of the third said. So area of paper of said 1 or the region 1 is 256 centimeter square. Area of the paper of the shed 2, region 2, is also 256 centimeter. And area of the paper of the shed 3, that is area of the paper of the shed 3, that is 17.92 centimeter square.
Thank you for joining us.